Hawaii is foundational for me. The raw ocean, the volcanoes, the rain, the forest. They wove their way into me somehow and became the center of whatever spiritual compass I have. And when the lyrics first started to come, it was about communicating to other people. The way I listened to the world outside when I was growing up was through songs. And I just wanted to be a part of that. And then when the music started to come, it was about something harder to explain. Music has always hit me on an emotional and physical level. Music to me is kind of sort of an emotional cloud. And the lyrics are sort of details that float inside that cloud and articulate parts of it. I started to make little cassette albums on my brother's 4-track recorder and sell them on consignment in the local record stores. And then I met a bunch of musicians who were playing in various bands. And I don't know, there was something just about the time, and we just all started meeting together and playing, and the camaraderie formed. And, you know, something happened, and there was kind of a mutual thirst for adventure. We were playing acoustically on the streets in Waikiki for fun and spare change. And we thought it would be a nice way to travel across North America for the adventure. And really, that's how it started. When we left, we had no idea where the road would take us, or even if we'd ever make it back home.
I think we were real, like, idealistic to begin with. We were like, as soon as reality's big ugly head comes along, we're just gonna bite it off. And it wasn't even like music, we just wanted to travel, you know. And once we got enough people, we just wanted to like go and just like, you know, see what happens, bring some money with us and see how far we got, you know. And music was there to begin with, so. You know, we thought maybe we'd play on the street too. We just didn't think about it realistically, and I guess that's what got us there.
There's just all these places that we just never seen before. And also, Woody Guthrie and Kerouac, like those cats writing and rambling, the whole glorifying of everyday existence was a total inspiration to us. And like Sean said, it's the only reason why we left there in the first place, because we were like idealistic, yeah, it'll be great, we'll do anything, rather than going, well, we won't have any money for this, we won't have any money for that. We didn't even think about that. We just like took it, we just went.
So I guess we should talk about the tour, because I guess maybe other, I don't know, you don't hear about people doing this too much, so. What, like, how did it come about, or?
We'd been playing on the street in Honolulu for fun, and we started kicking around the idea of traveling to the mainland, just, it's not really like a tour, but more, I guess, just like a way of getting money to travel to the next place to see the States and see all the different places and people and things like that. But we've been camping out every year we go, or just about. What we'll do is, we have a truck and sleeping bags and our instruments, and we travel around, and in between places where we know people, we camp out. We'll just like roll out sleeping bags wherever it is. And so we slept in all sorts of places. We slept in Stanley Park in Vancouver.
Which was really nice.
Which was actually really great. In the middle of the city, there's this wonderful park with rabbits and geese. And
we woke up and it was
yeah,
like
we went
New
to
York.
Park there just because of that little parking lot. Parked, got our stuff out, saw a launch, wake up, geese, rabbits, popcorn.
Oh, man, yeah. It was really funny. resting and reposing. My veins are pulsing. Nothing can cure me but your pulling touch. Nothing can cure me but your pulling touch. I'll stretch you out and lay alongside you. Run my hands along, devour and divide you. In the cool of the night, under a rain-pelted roof, beneath cotton, white, and linen, our love is spilled. You the cup that I call by the cheekbones. I pull you close and I drink you up. Are you the cup that I hold by the cheekbones? I pull you close and I drink you up. I'll stretch you out and lay alongside you. Run my hands along, devour and divide you.
Thank you. so I'm just going to go whack and just say, gotta wash them.
Okay.
Okay, here it comes.
You gotta wash them.
Softly called